closet, through my clothes, and found my cleanest dirty shirt. And then I washed my face and combed my hair, and stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs that I'd been picking. Then I lit my first and watched a small boy cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. Half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down. I guess the reason why you get the feeling lost and alone on Sunday morning, if you're anywhere but churches, well, that's where your mama took you when you was a kid. That's the way it was with me. And I'd wake up finding myself somewhere besides the church on Sunday morning. No matter if it was a church house or if it was a little corner in the house that I made for myself and called it a church on Sunday morning, I wasn't there, I was out of place for some reason. So you spend the rest of the day trying to figure out what it was that you lost. In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And then I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the songs that they were singing, like ringing in the sheaves. And then I went on down the road, and somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. I thought it echoed through the canyon like a disappearing dream of yesterday. Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. And they're eating of that short of dying. Oh.
Up in the morning feeling tired.
And old Lonnie can't remember when I came here how he tried to get me fired. With his folded hands behind his back, each morning Lonnie waited at the gate. He'd rant and rave like I'd committed murder, clocking in 5 minutes late. But today they'll gather round me like I've seen them do when any man retires. And old Lonnie's gonna tell me from now on I'm free to do what I desire. They'll present me with that little old gold watch they give a man at a time like this. But there's one thing he's not counting on, today's the day I'll give old Lonnie his. I've been working, building muscles, all he's been standing around to get the salt. And today about 4:30 I'll make up for every good night's sleep I've lost. When I'm gone I'll be remembered as a working man that put his point across. With the right hand full of knuckles, today I'll show old only who's the boss. Make a dedication out of somebody that hardly ever gets a dedication to the working man's wife, the woman that stands behind that good hard working man. I remember my mom finishing up the breakfast dishes and coming on out and getting in the field by 7 o'clock. Before we really got started good, she'd already cleaned up the house, was out the cotton patch. She'd go back in about 11 o'clock to cook dinner. Not lunch, dinner. Breakfast, dinner, and supper back then. And then she'd come back out about 1 o'clock and pick the rest of the day. Shout. Dedicate this to my mom. These hands aren't the hands of a gentleman. These hands are callous and low. Raised a family, these hands built a home, and now these hands raise to praise the Lord. These hands won the heart of my loved one, and with her they were never alone. If these hands fill their task, what more could you ask? For these fingers have worked to the bone. Cunningham. That pretty well.
These hands brought me happiness.
getting tired and getting old, and I'm getting silver where there was gold. Maybe things ain't been all that I planned, but God above, Him I plead when it's time to judge me. Take a look. Lord, she's wrestling like cotton candy clouds that sail the day, flowing free, and she possesses a mind that can resign itself to stay along with me. Though I've tried and tried to keep her tied and satisfied until she really needs me, yes I do. But when that certain look comes on her face, I can't replace it as she leaves me. She's a butterfly in mid-July who just can't wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows, she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Yes, she will, yes, she will. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. I know she needs me about as much as I need someone else, which I don't. And if need be, I swear someday I'll up and leave myself, which I won't. But even if she loved another man, I'd understand it more than I do. But I know the only reason that she ever has for leaving is she wants to. She's a butterfly in mid-July who just can't wait to try her brand new wings on brand new things. And she needs no rhyme or reason when she goes. Her mind is on what lies beyond that wall of blue horizon, I suppose. And heaven knows, she'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. She'll go sailing off on any old wind that blows. Years ago we were on Sun Records. We first started out. One of the greatest songwriting talents, performing artists in the world at his beginning too. His name was Charlie Rich. Here's just a little bit of one of his songs. You cut out your dancing and you never see a show. Friends come by to pick you up and you hardly ever go. It seems your head is in the clouds above. You've got the ways of a woman in love. I walk by your house at night and hope that I might see the guy that's got you in a spin. I wish that guy was me. I don't know why it's you I'm dreaming of. You've got the ways of a woman in love. I'm very honored tonight to have in the audience one of the world's greatest talents, Mr. Charlie Rich. Would you take a bow, Charlie? Charlie, put the light out there, will you? Well, he's out there somewhere. You would have liked the way he looked if you'd have seen him.
Hey, Charles. There he is.
At my door the leaves are falling. A cold wild wind will come. Sweethearts walk by together. And I still miss someone. I go out on a party and look for a little fun. But I find the darkened corner, 'cause I still miss someone. Though I never got over those blue eyes, I see them everywhere. I miss those arms that held me when all the love was there. I wonder if she's sorry for leaving what we've begun. There's someone for me somewhere. And I still miss someone. Faded as my jeans. Coffee black and diesel down just before it rained. Took us all the way to New Orleans. Then I pulled my harpoon out of my dirty red bandana and was blowing sad while Bobby sang the blues. With the windshield wipers clapping time and Bobby clapping hands, we finally sang a bitter song that's driving you. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing ain't worth nothing, but it's free. Feeling good was easy while Bobby sang the blues. Feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me and Bobby McGee. From the coal mines of Kentucky to the California sun, Bobby shared the secrets of my soul. Standing right beside me alone through everything I'd done, and every night she'd keep me from the cold. Then one day near Salinas, I let her slip away, looking for the home I hoped you'd find. And I'd trade all my tomorrows for one single yesterday, holding Bobby's body close to mine. Freedom's just another word for nothing left to lose. Nothing ain't worth nothing, but it's free. Feeling good was easy while Bobby sang the blues. Feeling good was good enough for me. Good enough for me and Bobby McGee. In a little cabaret in a South Texas border town, boy and his guitar, and the people came from all around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in up to take the trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy that sang the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play. And he never cared to make a dime, but given his guitar, and he'd be happy all the time, and all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy that played a Tennessee flat top box, and he would play let it get Bob. Then one day he was gone, and no one ever saw him round. He vanished like the breeze, but they forgot him in the little town. But all the girls still dreamed about him and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. Then one day, on the hit parade, was a little dark-haired boy that played a Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. This is a song that started it off for us. The first time we were ever in Little Rock, this is the first one we did. Luther Perkins played the guitar then. Nobody could ever touch his style. I want to thank Bob Wooten for doing a fantastic job on the guitar, though. Bob Wooten. Hey Porter, could you tell me the time? How much longer will it be till we cross that Mason-Dixon line? When we hit Dixie, would you tell that engineer to ring his bell and ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell? Hey Porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, would you tell that engineer to ring his bell and ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell? Let it get rockin'. Back downstream, the Morton and Davenport, and I followed you, Big River, when you called. Hey. sounded it coming, coming down that railroad track. Hey, look yonder coming.
Came up to me and he said, "What are you hanging around here for, Johnny?" And I said, "For whatever's going around." And then he said, "Ain't you worried about getting your nourishment in New York?" And I said, "I don't care if it's that, they talk about it rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. Rolling down a seaboard line." February 15th in Memphis will be the premiere of a movie called Gospel Road, a film produced by Jen and I about the life of Christ. An hour and a half film that tells our story. We tell the story. Part of the story is told in song. And I understand Gospel Road will be coming to Little Rock sometime between now and Easter. And we hope you get a chance to see it. It'll be running at one of the theaters here in town. Some very good songs in the film to help tell the story. One was written especially for a scene where a man called Nicodemus comes to Jesus and asks him some very important advice about how to get eternal life. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "You must be born again." Come down from your golden throne to me, to lowly me. I need to feel the touch of your gentle hand. Remove the chains of darkness and let me see, Lord, let me see just where I fit into
your master plan. I never thought I needed help before. I thought that I could get by myself. But now I know I just can't take it anymore. And with a humble heart on bended knee, I'm begging you, please help me. And Jesus said to Nicodemus, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Lord, help me to walk another mile, just one more mile. I'm tired of walking all alone. Lord, help me to smile another smile, just one more smile. I just can't make it on my own. I never thought I needed help before. What you mean, Nicodemus? I thought that I could get by myself. But now I know I just can't make it anymore. And with a humble heart on bended knee, begging you, please help me. Jesus walked the length and breadth of the land of Israel. He spoke his words of simple beauty, of peace and love and understanding. And everywhere he went, the people followed him in such multitudes that they walked on top of each other just to get close enough to touch the hem of his garment, the hem of his garment. Lord, touch the hem of his garment. He himself being the greatest miracle of all. And he came to the city of Bethsaida, and a blind man was brought to Jesus. And the blind man said, well, if you'd only stop and touch me, if you'd only stop and touch me, if you'd only stop and touch me, I know I could see. If you'd only stop and touch me, if you'd only stop and touch me, if you'd only stop and touch me, I know I could see. So Jesus touched me. He laid his hands on the blind man's eyes and he said, now open your eyes and tell me what you see. And I can almost see that man opening his eyes for the first time, looking around and seeing the dim outline of all the people around him. And he said, I see men as trees walking. I see men as trees walking. I see men as trees walking. I'm beginning to see. I see men as trees walking. I see men as trees walking. I see men as trees walking. I'm beginning to see. So Jesus touched him one more time. He put his hands on his eyes and he said, now open your eyes and look up and tell me what you see. And the man said, I can see all men clearly. I can see all men clearly I can see, all men clearly I've begun to see. I can see all men clearly, I can see all men clearly, I can see all men clearly I've begun to see.
Jesus named and numbered disciples. The number was 12. There was Peter, James, Andrew, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Canaanite, and Judas Iscariot. And he told them to go his way and preach his gospel. And for a very short ministry, the people were healed and the poor heard the gospel. Well, just before his time was come, at the house of a friend in an upper room, Jesus gathered around the table for a last supper with his friends, with his 12 disciples. And he was telling them that one of you will betray me and one of you will... Lord, is it I? Lord, is it I? Lord, is it I? Is it I? Will one of us be ashamed to mention your sweet name? Lord, is it I? Is it I? I can tell by your faces that you don't understand the awesome things you felt and seen at the touch of my hand. But someday you'll understand it when the Father means for you to. But for now, drink the cup and break the bread, and I'll eat my last supper here with you. Have a little bread, Simon. Pass the wine to James, my brother. Go ahead and eat, friend. And love one another. Have a good time, boys. 'Cause tomorrow I must die. And I'm never more gonna eat with you again. Till we eat the marriage supper in the sky. Have a good time, children. Though I'll not be long abiding, better eat now, brothers. 'Cause tomorrow you'll be hiding, fearing for your lives, fellas. 'Cause you follow after me. But after tomorrow you're never gonna fear again. I'm gonna loose the chains and set the captives free. Yes, I can tell by your faces that you don't understand the awesome things you felt and seen at the touch of my hand. But someday you'll understand it when the Father means for you to. But for now, drink the cup and break the bread, and I'll eat my last supper here with you.
Hope you'll be watching for Gospel Road. Came across that Arkansas River today. I was thinking about many, many years ago when I was a little bitty kid. We came across that river one cold, rainy January night, getting away from that flood water up in Mississippi County. That water come down from the Ohio. Every bit of it come right across our cotton patch, right up to our front doorstep. I heard my daddy holler and ask my mama, "How high is the water, mama?" "2 feet high and rising." "How high is the water, Papa?"
pipes are gone, I lost my bees, chickens are sleeping in the willow trees, cows in water up past her knees, 3 feet high and rising. How high is the water, mama? 4 feet high and rising. How high is the water, papa? She said it's 4 feet high and rising. Hey, come look through the window pane. The bus is coming, gonna take us to the train. Looks like I'll be blessed with a little more rain. 4 feet high and rising. Oh, how high is the water, mama? 5 feet high and rising. How high is the water, papa? She said it's 5 feet high and rising. The rails are washed out north of town. We gotta head for higher ground. We can't come back till the water goes down. 5 feet high and rising. Well, it's 5 feet high. Well, Ray Cash had a pretty rough time those years. Clearing that mud out of that house after the flood. Running the chickens and the cats and the dogs and the hogs out, so we could move back in when the water went down. But we planted a cotton crop the next year and it grew tall. I want to do this song for my daddy. Carl, you want to help me sing it for your daddy too? In a vine-covered shack in the mountain, bravely fighting the battle of time, there's a dear one who's weathered life's sorrow. It's that silver-haired daddy of mine. If I could recall all the heartache, dear old daddy, I've caused you to bear. If I could erase those lines from your face and bring back the gold to your hair, if God would but grant me the power just to turn back the pages of time, I would give all I own if I could but atone to that silver-haired daddy of mine. Thank you.
garden.
I'm going to mess around. Call me, I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town.
What?
What they don't know how. Well, I'm going to Jackson. You turn loose on my coat. Honey, I'm going to Jackson.
Carpenter, and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
If you were a carpenter, and I were a lady, I'd marry you anyway. I'd have your baby.
Save you up through loneliness, save you up through sorrow. I gave you my loneliness, give me your tomorrow. If I were a miller and a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your colored blouse and your soft shoes shining? I gave you my loneliness, give me your tomorrow. Take the ribbon from your hair, shake it loose and let it fall. Lay it soft against your skin, like the shadows on the wall.
Gonna lay down by my side in the early morning light. All I'm asking is your time.
Help me make it soon. understand. I don't care about tomorrow, 'cause tonight I need bread.
Do your act now. Let me get a little break. Yes, do your act, honey. Let's do one of your old routines. You know, I used to be such a fan of June Carter all my life. I was ever since I was a little bitty boy. And I used to go see at the Grand Ole Opry when I was in grade school. And I just really do like you. And I'd like to see you do one of your acts, will you?
Boy. You see what's happened. I went for years. I used to work with my family, the Carter family, you know, and I went through a long period of my life that I used to do comedy all the time, or that's what some people call it.
I still laugh a lot. I still laugh all the time, practically.
And then I've been real lazy. Like for the last 3 or 4 years, I was busy doing other things. I've been trying to just be Miss Johnny Cash and be a mama because I've got a little baby boy. And I've been looking after him, and I haven't done that kind of stuff in a long time.
Do you want to introduce him? Would you like to introduce Johnny
Carter?
You think
they might like to see him?
Is he back there?
No, I haven't got here, Johnny Carter. Where's my baby?
He's not a baby, he's my boy.
Where's my son? Where are you, son? Son, where are you?
Over
here? Back here, back there. There he is, way back there. Wave to the people, honey. Wave to the people. You're way back there, aren't you, honey? Well, I've been trying to look after him. Here, you've got me out here now. Since you've decided to be in concert, you've got me out here. Do you want me to do something like I used to years ago?
Yeah.
Okay, I will, just for means.
Well,
right. I'll tell you what I'll do. I did this in Little Rock a long time ago, and some of them might remember it, but I haven't done it in a long time, and I'm not sure that I know exactly how to do it, but I'll give you my interpretation of some people.
Okay.
I don't know how this is going to be. I'd like to show you a girl from Memphis who's tried to make it through the snow to get to Little Rock to see the Johnny Cash show tonight, and she's gotten out of the car. She's trying to come up to the front, and she has to cross a great big mud hole. This is a Memphis girl trying to come to Little Rock.
No, Carter lived here long.
Ha ha ha!
gave me a blanket to keep me from the cold.
And you gave me a song I learned to sing.
You showed me some beauty through the windows of your soul.
And you showed me a world I've never seen.
Each giving to the other, loving, giving it away.
We stripped the precious time we knew was borrowed.
'Cause you gave me the courage to live with yesterday. To light my way to bed.
And you erased all shadows I couldn't see.
You brought me a pillow to rest my weary head.
And you taught me a gentle way of dreaming.
And even if you leave me, I'll be richer when you go.
I'm richer with the loving you gave me.
'Cause you gave me a blanket to keep me from the cold.
And you gave me
a baby.
Thank you. undertaker. Undertaker won't you please drive slow on this lady. You are falling. Lord, I hate to see all those.
For me someday. Yeah.